You need to really ask yourself that day when death comes to you. Allah says in the Quran, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Kalla idha balagati taraqi wa qila man raq wa dhanna annahu al-firaq wal taffati saq bis saq. That day when the death, your nafs reaches your collarbone. Right here, Allah says, Kalla idha balagati taraqi, it reaches your collarbone. Kalla idha balagati taraqi wa qila man raq. And then the people say, where's the doctor? Where's the doctor? Call the doctor for her. She's about to die. He's about to die. وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقِ. And the person, it becomes clear to him and her that the doctor can't do anything for them. No one can help you today. You're alone. You start realizing that your legs start to lose its life. The nafs has been moved from your legs. It's been moved to your knees. It's going up. You're dying. Allah says, وَظَنَّ أَيْ تَيَقَّن. The person, it becomes clear to him and her, أَنَّهُ الْفِرَاقِ, that they're departing from this earth. إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسَاقِ. And the place that you're going towards is your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Going to Allah is that He knows everything about you. It's not, you're not going to somebody who doesn't know you. Allah knows everything about you. Everything about your affairs. Everything that you said, everything that you did. وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْهُ مِنْ قُرْآنٍ وَلَا تَعْمَلُونَ مِنْ عَمَلٍ إِلَّا كُنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ شُهُودًا إِذْ تُفِيضُونَ فِيهِ وَلَا يَعْزُبُ عَنْ رَبِّكَ مِنْ مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. أما في الأرض ولا في السماء. وَمَا يَعْزُبُكَ. Nothing is hidden from your Lord. You're going to stand in front of Him. You're departing from this earth. You're moving away, and you know you're heading towards that Lord. He knows everything about you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows your kha'inat al-a'yun wa ma tukhfi as-sudur, what you hiding in your chest. He knows what's in your mind. He knows what you really did that day when people thought you didn't do it. He knows all of your public and your private affairs. Prepare for that day, sisters, wallahi. Brothers, prepare. Recently, the other day, just last week, one brother, he lost his wife at the age of 25. His wife was 25 years of age. Death came and he knocked on his door. His brother's not from London. He's now going back to the city that he came from. He's lost his life. He's lost his wife. Death comes. It doesn't look at your age. It doesn't look at your background. It doesn't look at who you know and who you're linked with and your friends. It doesn't care. It will come and it will take you from this world. And the truth of the matter is that the only person who's going to be saved is the one who didn't take his religion as a joke. And he didn't play around with his deen. He was serious about his religion while he was alive. He saw this world to be a place of zara, that he plants his seeds. You know, if you haven't planted your seeds, when the harvest comes and the people are reaping their fruits and they're harvesting, you can't do that because you haven't put the effort in before, right? You can't because you didn't put the effort in. And that's why Allah says, فَالْيَوْمَ نَنْسَاهُمْ كَمَا نَسُوا لِقَاءَ يَوْمِهِمْ هَذَا. Today we'll forget them the way they forgot our meeting. Because you forgot the meeting of Allah, how did you forget? الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ هُزُوًا وَلَعِبًا وَغَرَّتْهُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. You took your religion as a joke. You took this world as the ultimate final goal for you. This was your ultimate goal. You only worked for this. You lived for this. You actually forgot there's another day left. There's another stage after this. You forgot that. وَلِذَلِكَ our messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, Aisha said in Sahih al-Bukhari, in the الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي تُوفِيَ فِيهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, on his deathbed, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would take both of his hands and he place it inside the water. And he would take it out. And he would take that palms of his and he would rub it on his face, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he would say to his wife Aisha, Inna lil mawti sakarat. Aisha, death is painful. Aisha said, radiallahu anha, I never saw anyone go through the agony of death the way that I saw the Prophet went through it. And I never sympathized with anybody after I saw the Prophet the way he suffered. On his last moments, the way that he was watery. She would get him a cloth, she would put it on his forehead, it would dry out because of so much that was coming out of him. And then when the angel came to him, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, he lifted his فَنَصَبَ يَدَهُ, he pointed his finger towards the sky, and the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, إِلَى الرَّفِيقِ الْأَعْلَى, I want to be with Allah high above. Aisha said, I realize that he has chosen the hereafter over this dunya. Ponder here. And as the Prophet was saying that, his nafs was coming out of his body and his finger dropped. Ponder here, why would the Prophet choose the hereafter? Because he worked for it. He knows he's got something there waiting for him. But the person who is not a righteous individual, he won't like that day. وَلِذَلْكِ he said in another hadith, مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ. Anyone who wants to meet Allah, Allah wants to meet them. And anyone who doesn't want to meet Allah, Allah doesn't want to meet you. Aisha said, when you say that the one who wants to meet Allah, Allah wants to meet him, and the one who doesn't want to meet Allah, Allah doesn't want to meet him, do you mean by death? Are you talking about death? And the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam said to her, no, ya Aisha, I'm not talking about death. But the believer, when he's on his deathbed and he's about to die, he will be shown his place in Jannah. And so he wants to meet Allah. And the disbeliever will be shown his place in the hellfire, and he doesn't want to meet Allah. And the reason why a person will be shown their Jannah is because they worked for it. When they were in the dunya, they were working hard. And they were putting efforts in. So my beloved brothers and sisters, today is your opportunity. Tomorrow when you come, as Allah said about the kuffar and the disbelievers, بَلْ بَدَى لَهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يُخْفُونَ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتِ. Allah says, كَلَّا إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. They will say, the sinners and the criminals will say, رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ, oh Allah, take me back to the earth one more time. I want to go back. I've not done good. I know I should have worked hard. Oh Allah, give me one more chance. That's what they will say. Allah will say to them, إِنَّهَا كَلِمَةٌ هُوَ قَائِلُهَا وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. كلا, that's not going to happen. Can't happen. ولذلك, the Salaf, what they used to do was, they used to benefit from that opportunity, my beloved brothers and sisters. Meaning, they used to practice that now that they were alive in this world. How would they practice it? The poet, he said, يُمَثِّلُ ذُو اللُّبِّ فِي لُبِّهِ مَصَائِبَ قَبْلَ أَن تَنْزِلَ فَإِنْ نَزَلَتْ بَغْتَةً لَمْ تَرُعُّ لِمَا كَانَ فِي نَفْسِهِ مَثَلًا وَذُو الْجَهْلِ يَا مَنْ أَيَّامَهُ وَيَنْسَى مَصَارِعَ مَنْ قَدْ خَلَى فَإِنْ دَهِبَتْهُ صُرُوفُ الزَّمَانِ بِبَعْضِ مَصَائِبِهِ أَعْوِلَى. They would actually bury, they will actually dig a hole in their own house. And they will lie inside it. And then they will say to themselves, قَالَ رَبِّ رِجَعُونِي, oh Allah, take me back to the earth again one more time. لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ, so I can do some righteous actions that I left behind. And guess what they would do? They would come out of the hole and they would take off the dust from themselves and they would come out and they would say to themselves, you've been given a chance now. You've been given a chance now. Work hard and put in efforts. And so he would go and he would put so much effort in making sure that they did righteous deeds.